Hello, this is Cristi. Let me show you my favorite three animations in Camtasia. I always said that the custom animation is the only animation you ever need. And yes, you can use just that animation and accomplish anything you like. Custom animation is my first one and it's my favorite. I'm going to use this example here, a tutorial I recorded and I'm about to edit to show you my animations. The first one is obviously the custom animation. You go to animations on the top left and you find it right there. It is one of my favorite animations. And I usually don't go in here for this animation because I add the animation using the shortcut key Shift and A. So the easiest way to do it, select your clip. So let's say that I want to zoom in to the top left corner of this video. All I have to do is go to the point where I want to be zoomed in and Shift and A. That will add the animation onto the video clip. And then I have to just scale up this clip to the point I need to go. On the Mac, I need to zoom out to make some room for myself and then allows me to move this in more. And now if I center this, you will see that I'm going to play this and look, it's zooming into that corner right there. So that is the custom animation. And of course, you can add it as many times as you like to any clip and it will just move the object wherever you want it to go, zooming in, zooming out, and so on. So my second animation is called Restore. And I wasn't using this in the past, but now it's so useful to use it. Here's why. I'm going to mute that clip for a second. So here's why. I have zoomed in to this corner, but I may want to go back to the previous zoom. Restore will do that for you. I used to be going manually and creating a Shift and A, custom animation, zoom out, and then grab the video and put it back in here. This is very tedious and it requires a lot of clips and you may not even do it accurately. So watch this. I'm going to remove this animation here. So there you go. This is my first animation zooming in, but then I want to go back. After I'm done showing whatever I'm showing in this corner, I say I want to go back to the previous zoom and I'm ending up around here maybe. And I say, let's restore. Restoring means animate my video or object back to where it was before. So there it is. Restore. Drag this to your clip and just like this, it goes back to what it was. And here we go. It goes back to where it was. But that's not everything. The restore animation doesn't just go back to full screen. It goes back to the previous position the object was in before you added the last animation. If this doesn't make sense, I understand. Let's have a look what it does. So I zoomed in and then I applied restore, which brought me back to full screen like this. But then let's say that I want to show something in that corner again, right after going full screen. Maybe I need to say something else in the top left corner. No problem. I don't have to add a custom animation anymore. I will just use the restore animation again. And the restore animation is going to return my video to where I was before the last animation. That's basically what it is. I can't explain it any better. So grab the restore and let's say that I've gone back now to full screen and go back in here and I say, oh, I need to show you something else from the corner. Great. Get the restore and put it here. And look, I am back to the corner, right? So restore will always put you back where you were before you applied the last animation. I said this three times already. So the nice thing with this is that if you have a tutorial or something you want to show or a video you want to scale to a point and then go back, scale again there, go back and again, and you need to go back and forth between two positions in your screen, the restore operation will keep doing that for you. Look, I'm going forward, apply restore, there it is, back to full screen. Go forward, apply restore again, there it is, back to the corner, and so on. And this also animates the cropping. So here's another cool tip. If I click restore again to just put it back into the full screen, so I need to say, well, I want to zoom in, but I also want to crop. And cropping is actually something that you need to do once and, you know, remember that position and then do it again with the restore because cropping the video over and over again in the same position is very tedious, right? So let's suppose that I have an animation that I add here a custom animation, and I'm going to hold down the Option key or Alt on Windows to go to crop mode, and I will crop just to this corner right there. And to add to the complexity, I will also zoom in there, right there. So there it is. My object is now cropped and scaled with this animation. So from here, I went to this. Right there. So you see, both have been animated, the cropping and the resizing. Now, how do I go back to what I had before? Well, I would have to click on this and add another animation and Option key again, remove the crop and all of that. Well, I don't want to do that. All I want to say is, you know what? I want to go back to what I was doing. Restore again. Restore animation just brings me back. It removes the cropping, puts it back in, and scales the object back. Watch what happens. This is going back in here and now going back out. The restore animation just moves you between states like this. Really useful. So here's the third favorite animation that I use, and this was very easy. I should have shown the second, really. If I do anything in my video, like even zooming out and resizing and moving it around like this, and I'm like, oh, I don't know what I'm doing here because I have moved this video all over the place, how do I get back to what I had before, like full screen? Not back to the previous crop or anything. Full screen, back to full screen. Well, that is the third animation I want to show you, which is called Scale to Fit. There it is, Scale to Fit. Whatever happens to your video, it doesn't matter where you are, how much you've scaled it up, Scale to Fit will bring it right back to full screen, make it fit in the viewport or canvas. So there you go. I'm doing all this cropping, I'm doing the scaling, zooming in, zooming out, all of that stuff. I'm moving all over the place, but watch this now. It all goes into full screen and it makes everything fit on the screen. Scale to Fit. There it is. And this works actually for objects that are smaller as well. For example, if I want to animate my own camera to scale to fit, but animate it, I will just grab Scale to Fit, place it on my video, and there it is. From that corner, it goes to full screen and makes it fit to as tall or wide as it needs to be. So even if it's not the exact same aspect ratio, the Scale to Fit will make sure that your object occupies the largest space it can possibly fit without going outside of the canvas. So there is my third favorite animation. So very nice, very easy to use these animations, and I have them all in my favorites. If I press F, I have them all in my favorites right here. Restore, Scale to Fit. And I don't have the custom one because I usually use the keyboard shortcut for it, Shift and A, both on Mac and Windows. That shortcut will add a custom animation ending at the playhead on whatever clip you have selected. So there are other animations that are pre-built in Camtasia. Usually you can find them in the animations here. You've got no opacity or full opacity, which is really the equivalent of a fade in and fade out, right? But animated. So if I want to fade my video out, all I have to say is go to a point, drag the no opacity, and there you have it. My video will now fade out, and then full opacity will bring it right in, right there. You see, like that. So you can use these animations that are pre-built for various things. Thank you for watching. I hope this was useful. My three favorite animations in Camtasia, and they're saving me a lot of time, and I use them all the time in my projects to quickly move things around on the screen. Again, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you on the next one.